Hey everybody, my name is Ellen Arsenault and I'm a phys ed and health teacher at Miscouche School. And I am very happy to be here today and take you through some skillful movements and some exercises that really are going to allow you to be active for life. These are exercises that you can use any time and any place as long as you have a safe space to move around. They really don't require a lot of equipment at all, if any, and you can do them by yourself, you can do them with somebody else, you can also do them in a group. So we're going to be doing some upper body, core, and lower body exercises. We're going to talk about some key points of these exercises that are really going to help you get the benefits from them and help you do them safely to avoid injury. And speaking of avoiding injury, before we get into it, we want to start off with a warm-up. This is something that is really going to get our heart rate up and ready to work out. It's also going to loosen up our muscles and just get our entire body totally ready to get into exercise without getting hurt. And we always want to try and prevent injury as much as we can. So let's get warmed up. We're going to start off with some twists. So we're just going to get our body moving. You can extend your arms out like this, or you can tuck them in close to your body. So we're just going to start and go ahead. And we're going to move side to side. And you can follow along with me and do this for about 15 to 20 seconds, just until your body and your core feels stretched out and warmed up, and you can feel yourself starting to breathe a little bit harder and your heart race a little bit faster. Great. And now we'll do some arm circles. So this is going to be really great to stretch out our shoulder muscles. So we'll go pick one direction first and we'll start off and do about 15. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and now we'll switch and go the opposite way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Awesome. And now we're going to work our way down. We're going to work our whole body. This time we're going to do some jumping jacks and get our legs and our lower body involved. So let's do 25 together. Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Awesome. So we are going to do some kicks. So what you're going to do is you're going to start off with either your right or left, and you're going to put the opposite arm up in the air. So I'm going to start with the left. I'm going to kick up and touch my toe. Pick up with my right and touch my toe. Okay, and we're going to do about 8 each. So we'll do 16 total. So we'll go, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. All my muscles are loose, my heart rate is up, and I'm ready to do a little bit more intense activity. So what we're going to be doing today is three different exercises. One is for our core, and that's the sit-up. One is for our lower body, and that's the squat. And the third is for our upper body strength, and that is the push-up. We're going to start off with the sit-up. So I'm going to start the sit-up with a crunch. A crunch is kind of similar to a sit-up, but you don't actually come up all the way. So you're only coming up about one-fourth or one-third of the way. So when you do a crunch, the key points is that you want to keep your feet flat on the ground. So if you need help with this, you can tuck your toes underneath something to keep your feet grounded. If you're with someone else, they can hold your feet down. But if you can do this without anything holding your feet down, that's great too. So we're going to start off with a crunch. When you're laying down on the ground in your starting position, you can put your hands behind your head, or I like to cross them over my chest. This is comfortable for me. So when we do a crunch, we only come up about one quarter of the way. But notice that my shoulder blades and my neck are off the ground. So I'm not just using my head, okay? I'm using my whole shoulder blades and neck to come up off the ground. And then I'm returning to the starting position. So we are going to do some crunches together, and I'm going to play a song along with our exercise, and I do not own the rights to this song. It is called Flower by Moby. You can find this song on YouTube Music, and it's a really great song to exercise too because of the lyrics in the song. The words that you're going to hear are bring Sally up, and you're going to move your body upward. And then you're going to hear bring Sally down, and then you're going to move your body downward. So I'm going to try this now, and I'd love if you guys would join along with me to the song. So let's do some crunches together. So remember the two main points: you want to keep your feet grounded, and you want to make sure that your shoulder blades and neck come off the ground. Okay, so we're going to start here. 3, 2, 1. Our leg muscles are included in that. So when we do a squat, there's two key points. One is that you want to keep your chest and your head up. So we don't want to lean forward. We want to keep our chest up straight. Another very major point of a squat that we need to make sure we do so we avoid injuring ourselves is we need to keep our knees directly above our toes. So we don't want our knees to buckle in, and we don't want to have them out too far either. So we want to keep them just right above our knees. So when we do a squat, I'll do three right now. You can do them with me. My chest is up, my knees are above my toes. One, two, three. Okay, so we're gonna try this with the music. For the squat, it's a little different because you're going to be waiting a little bit longer. So you're really gonna feel the burn and feel your lower body muscles getting worked out. So let's go here in three, two, one. Okay, so that is push-up number one. Number two is called an incline push-up. So when you do an incline push-up, you can use any object. A chair is really good, but you always want to make sure that it's sturdy enough and it's not going to slide on you or move. So I'm just going to test this one out and it's nice and sturdy. So I'm going to place both hands on the chair. And I'm going to go down onto my knees on the mat for this push-up. And I just want to make sure, again, my hands are directly under my shoulders. And there's a straight line from my shoulder to my knees. I don't want to have too much of an arch in my back either way. I want to make sure my back is nice and straight so I avoid hurting it. And I'm going to do three of these. One, two, and three. Okay, so that is our second type of push-up. Our third type, and it's getting a little bit harder, is going to be on the mat. Again, hands are under my shoulders, my knees are on the ground, and again, I have a straight line from my shoulder to my knees. There's no big arch in my back, so I'm nice and straight. And I'm going to do three, and you can do them with me. One, two, three. Okay, and now we'll do the final type of push-up, which is the most difficult. So again, hands under shoulders. This time there's a straight line from my shoulder step. One, two, and three. Awesome. So you at home can pick any type that is comfortable for you, and we're going to do them together. So we're going to turn the song on, and remember to listen to the words for your signal to go up and to go back down. Okay, let's do this in three, two, one.
Thank you.
the song. And it's time to cool our bodies down. We want to bring our heart rate, which is now up pretty high, back down to normal. And we want to really stretch the muscles that we just used so that they're nice and loose and we're not too sore tomorrow. So we're going to start with a really easy light cool down. And what we're going to do first is just stretch out our arms, which we used for the push-up, and our upper body strength exercise. So we'll start with one arm, pull it across our body, and give it a nice stretch for our shoulder and our arm. And we always want to make sure we do these stretches for about 15 seconds and switch and do the opposite side for the same amount of time so that, again, we get an equal balanced stretch. So that was about 15 seconds, and we'll switch and go the other side. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, we also want to stretch out our core because we use that a lot during our crunches and our sit-ups. So we're going to reach one arm up high into the sky, and we're going to stretch over top of our head. Five, four, three, two, one. And we'll switch into the other side. I can feel my heart rate coming down, getting back to normal. Five, four, three, two, one. Great. So this time we're going to stretch our legs. We're going to pull one leg in and reach out and try and reach as far as we can. If you can't reach your toes, that's okay. You can place your hand on your shin, or even your knee, that's fine too. We just want to feel a stretch in the back of our legs. So we really worked them during our squats, so we want to stretch them out. Okay, that was about 15 seconds. So we'll switch. I'm going to tuck this leg in and reach out. Okay, so we've cooled down and we've really just brought our entire body and our heart rate and our breath back down to normal so we can go about our day. Thank you all so much for watching. Bye!
Hi there. Welcome to Music Ed Talk. I'm Steve Giddings. I teach music at Montague Consolidated School. Today we're going to learn how to compose our own music at home with the instruments we have at home. So what you'll need for this is some paper, pencils, markers, crayons, anything that you can color or draw with, and a musical instrument. And it doesn't have to be any of the instruments you see around here. It could be anything that makes a sound. So that leaves it pretty wide open. Okay, now while you're going to get those things, I have a few instruments here I want to get ready. So, I got my ukulele here, and the first thing we're going to do is make up a song about what you did yesterday, but there can't be any words, it's just sound. Okay? So see if you can guess what I did based on what you hear coming from a ukulele. Okay? Can you guess what I did? That's a good guess. No, what I did was walk, then run, then walk. I was chasing after my son on his bike. And so I had to run sometimes to keep up with him and slow down when he slowed down. Now, can you hear that in there? Listen again. There now? Great. So now we're going to figure out a nice, fun way to write it down or draw it. Okay, now yours will look different and sound different than mine, and that's the point. It's supposed to. It doesn't have to sound or look exactly like mine at all. It can be something completely different. Maybe you draw a picture of what you did, but right now, here's how I'm going to do mine. So I'm just going to do some dots. Draw the sound. Okay, that's my walking. Da, da, walk, 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 walk. And then my running, it was faster, but the notes were longer and they overlapped, so it's going to look different. Right? That's my running, 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 running. Okay, and then back to my walk, walk. Kind of hear the walk, step, step, right? Now, you can keep it at this, and maybe you want to add to it. Maybe you want to connect the dots and make some cool triangle shapes. Maybe you want to draw a runner on some of these lines here. That's completely up to you, whatever your piece is supposed to look like. What would be fun after this is if you gave this to somebody to see if they could play it just on what it looks like. Do you think they could? Give it a try. Now, there's another way you could do this. You could start with the picture. And you can draw whatever you want. You can draw shapes. You could draw a scene. With you outside in the sun with the house there, you can do that. Or you can draw shapes, which is what I'm going to do. Now I'm just gonna use blue. It doesn't matter what color you use, but we're gonna start like this. I'm gonna draw a spiral. Okay. Triangle. Squiggle. How would these sound? Interesting. Circle. Four random dots. And a waterfall. Okay. Now how would I play these? I have the perfect instrument for this. Have you ever seen a slide whistle? It's a whistle that changes shape. It sounds like this. So this is perfect for these. So I'm going to play a spiral, okay? And see if you can hear a spiral. Did you hear it? It got smaller, bigger, bigger, bigger. Okay, here's the triangle. Now I'm going to play the circle and see if you can hear that. Are you hearing these shapes? Great. Now, those just kind of sound like sounds. They're not really a piece of music yet, but they could be. So this time I'm just going to play each shape and see if you can follow along where I am on the page. And you'll notice they'll start to fit together, okay, into one piece of music. So here we go. Hear that? Didn't that sound a lot cooler when it was all together like that? Sounds more like a real piece of music now. Very good. So that's two ways that you could compose some music at home. I'm going to show you one more way that you can do it. It's a little more concrete than this. This is pretty abstract, which abstract basically means anyone could look at this and have a completely different interpretation of it. Okay? Concrete means it would make it sound a little bit more like it's supposed to sound, depending on who you give it to. Okay? And if you understand the language, then anyone you give it to will be able to play it. Okay? And some of the things we're going to be talking about here might be a little more familiar to you from your music class. So the first thing I'm going to do is come up with just a pattern, a repeating four-beat pattern. Okay? So, for example, here's my four-beat pattern. Okay? So, pretty simple, four beats. You may be familiar with ta, ta, ti, ti, ta, or ta, 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 di, ta. Okay? Now, you probably know how to write some of those. If you don't, that's okay. You're going to learn today. So those are rhythms that I was saying. Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. That's how short or long the note is played for. Okay? So I'm going to keep that pattern. Yours can be completely different. I'm just going to write down the rhythm first. So ta, 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 di, or ti, ti, and ta. Okay? I'm just going to write in the notes underneath. So my notes were C, D, E, E, D. So I'll just write those in here. And I'm going to decide how many times I'm going to play that. And music really likes 2, 4, and 8 groups. They like those numbers a lot. So I'm going to just say 2. Okay, let's play for 2 and see how that sounds. That sounds fine. I think I'll keep that. So I'll put times 2 to remind me that it's twice there. All right. Now, this is just the beginning. We need a beginning, a middle, and an end. All right. So we're going to call this the A section because it's the first part of our song. Okay. So we're going to come up now with another part to the song, the middle. And we want it to sound like it fits with this song. So just to keep things simple for today, I'm going to keep the same rhythm, but I'm going to change the notes. So we're still going to be ta, ta, ti, ti, ta, or ta, 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 di, ta. But the notes are going to change. So I'm just going to write down here that rhythm, because we know we're going to use that for our next section of the song. Now I'm just going to change the notes. I like that. E, F, G, G, E. So I'll write those in. Okay. Now, I think I'll do that twice as well. And I'll see how that sounds together. So I'm going to play this twice, that twice, and see if it flows well. Yeah, I think I like how that fits together. So let's call that the B section. Okay, because it's the second part, and it's the second letter in the alphabet, so that makes sense. Now, to finish this off, I'm just going to play an A section, a B section, then I'm going to go back to the A section, but I'm going to play the ending just slightly different to make it sound like it's over, okay? And then that'll be our song. So we're going to go A, B, A, like that, okay? So see if you can follow along. Just remember, I'm changing the end slightly to make it sound like it's over. Here we go. Did you catch what I did there? The very last note was different. And it made it sound like it was done. So that is our beginning, our middle, and end. And sometimes you don't know what your theme is going to be going in. You just start playing and you come up with ideas at work and you write them down. And if you don't like it, don't write it down. If you like it, put it on your paper. Okay? And that's all there is to it. Have lots of fun with this, and we'll see you next time on Music Ed Talk.
Good morning, boys and girls. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do, do, mi, so, do. Let's do that a little faster. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do, do, mi, so, do, so, mi, do. Good morning, everybody. My name is Mrs. Zink. Today, I would like to focus on the concept of tempo. And tempo is the speed of music. Some songs go very, very, very quickly, and other songs are very, very slow. Sometimes we can have the same song that changes tempo. In other words, it changes speed. This morning, we're going to start with two songs that you probably already know. The first time we sing it, we're going to sing it very slowly, and then we'll get a little bit faster and a little bit faster. Our two warm-up songs are Head and Shoulders, Knees and Toes, and The Grand Old Duke of York. I'd love it if you would sing along with me.
Head and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head and shoulders, knees and toes, eyes, ears, mouth and nose. Head and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head and shoulders, knees and toes, eyes, ears, mouth and nose. Head and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head and shoulders, knees and toes, eyes, ears, mouth and nose. The grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. But when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down. The grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. But when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down. Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. But when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down.
For the next part, I would like to tell you the story of the tortoise and the hare. The hare is a very quick animal, and he sings a song that is very, very fast. The tortoise is a very slow animal, and she sings a song that is very, very slow. The two songs each have their own tempo. Once upon a time, there was a foolish and selfish hare who was a very fast runner. He went about the land singing about how speedy he was.
I'm the fastest bunny rabbit, running is my happy habit. I'm the fastest bunny rabbit, catch me if you can.
A tortoise lived in the same land as the hare and grew tired of hearing him brag all the time. She thought that if she practiced walking every day, she could beat the hare in a race. And so she practiced, and every day you could hear her singing her slow song.
Slow and steady, always ready.
One day, the tortoise decided to challenge the hare to a race. The hare laughed at the tortoise. How could the tortoise possibly beat the hare? That was ridiculous. And so the hare accepted the challenge and got ready for the race, all the while singing his speedy song.
I'm the fastest bunny rabbit, running is my happy habit. I'm the fastest bunny rabbit, catch me if you can.
Soon it was clear that the hare was far ahead and long out of sight, but the tortoise continued her slow and steady pace, singing her slow song as she went along.
Slow and steady, always ready, I can get where I must go.
Meanwhile, the hare began to tire. He looked around, couldn't see the tortoise anywhere, and decided that maybe he'd have a nap. He listened for the sound of the tortoise, but all he could hear was the sound of the wind in the trees. As he drifted off to sleep, he hummed his little song.
I'm the fastest bunny rabbit, running is my happy habit. I'm the fastest bunny rabbit, catch me if you can.
The tortoise passed the sleeping hare, slow and steady. She got closer and closer to the finish line, and as she approached, she sang her steady song.
Slow and steady, always ready.
Tortoise won the race, and on that day, the hare learned that slow and steady wins the race. Our last song is called Going on a Bear Hunt. I would love it if you would echo sing with me. You'll find that our tempo will change as we go on our adventure.
I'm going on a bear hunt. I'm gonna catch a big one.
I'm not scared. What a beautiful day. Uh-oh. Grass. Long wavy grass.
Can't go over it. Can't go under it. going on a bear hunt. I'm gonna catch a big one. I'm not scared. What a beautiful day. Uh-oh. Mud. Thick, gooey mud. Can't go over it. Can't go under it. We'll have to go through it. Shoo, 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 shoo. Going on a bear hunt. I'm gonna catch a big one. I'm going on a bear hunt. I'm gonna catch a big one. I'm not scared. What a beautiful day. Back through the grass.
Thank you for singing with me as we explored tempo. It was fun singing fast and slow. Bye-bye.